This morning when I woke up, I thought to myself, boy, the time is really going quickly. And we knew it was only going to be a weekend, but it seemed to have gone pretty quickly, maybe because we're having so much fun. So I'm very excited to see you all here. Very, very excited. And the room looks fabulous, and you look gorgeous. Thank you for being here. There are a couple of things I'd like to share with you. And of course, as I promised this afternoon, I'd like to pin the area governors and division governors that are present. You know, when we invited Jose Alvarado, is he here? No. But when we invited Jose to do the affirmation for the opening ceremony, he asked, what are we expecting? And we did say to him, we want you to set the tone for the conference. And I believe he did just that. And if we were to select the slogan from this conference, what would it be? Join Toastmasters, stay active. And I'd like to ask the Puerto Rico Toastmasters to tell Jose how pleased we are with his affirmation and the fact that he gave us a slogan which resonated throughout the conference. One of the persons who was very integral to the start of Toastmasters in Puerto Rico, a member of the district, is Roxanne Albertina. She actually sent a recorded message because she was so sorry that she would not have been here. The message could not be played, but I wanted to tell you that Roxanne is extremely disappointed that is not here. She congratulates the Puerto Rico Toastmasters for building 3 clubs in 3 years, and she wishes us a successful conference. I believe we can report to Roxanne that this has been and will continue to be a successful conference. Would you agree with me? So, Vanessa, may I ask you to deliver to Roxanne the message that we appreciate her thoughts sincerely and that Puerto Rico continues to grow and they are appreciative of how she helped to start the club. Earlier this year, in August, Toastmasters International unveiled the brand refresh. As a result, several pieces of literature, several pieces of paraphernalia were unavailable until after the convention, including pins for all of us, and manuals for the club officers, etc. Since August 17, they have been sending out the material, and I am pleased this evening to be able to invite those area governors and division governors that are present to accept their new pins. And I'm going to invite Roland, the Lieutenant Governor of Education Training, to assist me. And just be aware that I'm ensuring that the pins for the others get to the countries. For example, Kenneth Bono is here, and his wife Francesca is the area governor for SVG, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, so he will take that. Darwin is here from Trinidad and Tobago. I'll ensure that the area governor's pin gets to Trinidad. So all of them will go to the area governors via the persons that are here. May I invite Linda Graham and Sharon Puria, district division governors present, to come forward to be pinned.
Thank you.
invite Abdul Ali from the US Virgin Islands to come forward. Annette Burkell from St. Martin. Dawnette Caliste from Grenada. Rodrigo Cyrus from Haiti. Continue to carry the fly the flag of the district high, and the clubs will benefit certainly from your activities. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight you will see a number of persons, clubs, areas, divisions getting awards. Today I mentioned that, well, I referenced the fact that we did so well individually, I'm going to say. Of the four divisions in District 81, we had one distinguished division, three presidents distinguished division. Of the 24 areas that we had last year, 19 were distinguished or better. And of the 101 clubs, it's about 64 clubs were distinguished or better. We did fantastically well last year, and I want to congratulate all the winners and say to you, keep up the good work. We have more to do in 2011, 2012, and we know that District 81 will be better off because of your efforts. I wish you a pleasant evening, but before I go, I want to take the opportunity to say thanks to the Puerto Rico team. They have been outstanding. And I want to really thank you. There are some volunteers who really, really went beyond the call of duty, and we really appreciate it. You have welcomed us, you have really been hospitable to us, and help us feel that you are our legs, our hands, right here in Puerto Rico. Thank you so much for your effort and your time, and you will hear from us on this matter. Mr. LGF.